Get your voice heard. When everybody is out there on the streets just waiting to go viral, you have another opportunity. And that is to come to Anchor.fm. Download the free Anchor app and join us here at the What's the Play family. And make sure that you DM us here, Steven, at Who Cares the Podcast, or go to info@whatstheplay.net so you can join our family. We'll promote the shit out of you. We will promote everything about you. Make sure you're cool. We're not going to promote some of you weirdos. We're going to make sure we promote you because everybody needs their voice to be heard. Everybody during this time needs that voice, right? Don't you need that voice? You can go global tomorrow. Just join Anchor.fm. Go to Anchor.fm to get started, all right? But make sure more than all that you join the What's the Play family. Info@whatstheplay.net will help you set it up, will help you go through all the situational things that you need to do. And tomorrow morning, we'll make sure that you get your voice heard.
There you go. You can hear both of us now.
Oh, I can. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome once again to the Who Cares Podcast.
I'm just kidding.
Starring me, Stephen with a PH, and the lovely
Tori Michaels.
Pleasure to meet you again this week.
No, it's a pleasure to meet you again, too.
You're looking so sexy in your schoolgirl outfit. Uh-oh, here he comes. Is it coming in?
I think we're having our guest.
Is it coming in?
Star coming
in. But what is happening right now?
I think that...
Oh, that was just my phone. Okay.
So.
Whatever, we're doing the ghetto version again.
This?
Anyways, yes, Ms. Torment, let's start this over. Welcome to the Who Cast Podcast. Starring me, Stephen with the PH, and you.
Tori Michaels.
The lovely Ms. Tori Michaels, who is in her Catholic school uniform, looking Catholic as always, even though she's evangelical. Or she's not, no domination. No domination.
Baptized Lutheran.
Lex Lutheran.
Oh, goodness.
How
Superman.
Do you feel?
I feel great. How are you doing tonight?
I'm doing well. Thank you again for a wonderful Monday. Carne asada.
So good.
And carne asada that was so good that the people that work in the building were able to come down and use the pool, and they thought, wow, that's amazing that we can use this pool now that the people have left the pool. And the smell of your carne asada.
I think it attracted them.
I think so too.
It was like a magnet.
As soon as
they
came, yeah.
They're like the people of the carne.
The carne. So, Ms. Tori Michaels, we got to move this thing along because last week, we were just getting started in this thing, this whole situation.
Mm-hmm.
All of this is brought to you by What's the Play. The Who Cares podcast is brought to you by whatstheplay.net or go to @whatstheplay app on Twitter, and there you will find the video for the YouTubes. You will find our Twitch channel here, and you will also find our Discord where you can be part of the community.
Sign up for that Discord. You can find the link inside the bio on our Twitter.
Yes.
That's What's the Play app.
On Twitter. And their secret prizes and secret love will be given to you.
Oh, yes. But is it really that big of a secret? You just heard it.
Oh, shit. Well, it is because everybody that's listening to it is actually an amazing person and so sick, so definitely in tune with the world. So I would say yes, they are. This is a secret society. What would you call the secret society? Because we don't want to call it anything to do with like Illuminati's hormones. We would call it what?
The SS?
Jesus Christ! Not during this
secret
time.
Society.
Oh yeah, we're not. Yeah, we don't want to do that.
Oh, you were going another direction.
Yeah,
No. I was not going that direction.
Well, you are white.
Wow, no, I am a multicultured.
Mexican? You're Mexican.
Yes.
Italiano.
Italiano.
Paisano.
So, did you do anything fun this weekend?
I did a lot of things fun. You know what? I saw that some people have been watching this.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to the people that are watching this. You know who you are.
Mm-hmm.
Clipping it, shoving it back. Clip snip.
Snip.
I did this weekend. Yeah, actually, I played golf with my dad. And today, rest in peace, all the other stores that now have to be closed.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, I'll turn this around.
It's horrible.
Yeah, it is.
Starting tomorrow?
We live in California here, so the governor, Gavin Newsom, mm-hmm. has now made it official. Everything is being closed down. I can't go to the gym anymore. Just when I'm feeling, just when I'm getting my perfect, fantastic, like, V shape back. Yeah. Just when I'm getting my V shape back, they want to take it away from me. They want to take everything away from me.
Everything.
They want to take it away.
I don't think everything.
They're taking my rights away.
No, I think that you're just motivation.
Well, I mean, you know.
Because when you take the gym from people, that's what I'm saying. Takes their motivation.
What about when you want to get your hair did?
You know, there are other ways to work out.
I've been doing that, but they tell me I can't do that either because Corona.
No, I mean, like, go in nature and work out. Hiking.
Bears have Corona, too. So you got this for me. I don't know if I busted this out last time. I'm not bougie at all, I promise. I think I did. It was a Chanel mask.
I think you're more bougie than anything.
Before we started?
Your dad liked it, though.
Yeah, my dad, I couldn't believe he knew. I mean, yeah. I mean,
he's all about Chanel.
He had to buy my mom some stuff when they're dating. And they're loving each other, you know?
How long have you been together?
Jesus, like 45 years, 50 years.
Wow.
30 years.
That's commendable.
35 years? 45? Somewhere between that. Take my age plus 4 or 5 years.
Do they still like each other?
So like 45, what?
They still like each other?
Yeah. Oh. No, crazy, right? I mean, we've known each other for what? 10, 15 years?
Since I was like 19. I'm 30 now. So it's been a while.
Man. You're 19.
What?
Just kidding.
Oh, goodness.
No, you don't look a day. You actually haven't changed. No, you haven't.
You haven't changed that. I think you looked younger now than you did back then.
Yeah, well, I was very serious back then.
Yeah, you wore suits all the time. Mm. Little
shaved head.
Bulkier. More like, yeah, like.
Yeah, and you know what? Then I realized it's okay to be slim.
Yeah. I think there was, too much muscle. You know?
Yeah, too much. Because people wanted to fight me all the time.
Oh, really? Is that because?
I'd be bulky.
Why did they want to fight you?
I have a face, I guess, that people want to fight.
I thought you had a face.
You're pretty much the only person that's been kind to me.
You're so bullshit.
But you know what? You have been very kind to me. You actually talked me down. I was actually going crazy a little bit earlier. Everybody, I know it seems like I have a very calm demeanor, but I was actually losing my goddamn mind.
Earlier. With our technical difficulties?
Yeah.
But usually in those situations, like with anybody, whenever they're going through like a frustration thing or they can't figure something out, usually you just stop, take a breath, and then just relook and reanalyze it, like walk away and then come back. Then I know it sounds really cheesy, but
it doesn't.
But like usually the things you're looking for are right in front of your face.
The mic?
Well, whatever. I'm just saying, like. You could be frantically looking for something,
like,
and then
your
you're
friendship.
Like, oh, that's cute.
I'm
serious. You touched my
covers on. So what should our secret society be called? Like the Who Cares podcast, right? That's the name of the book. But we don't want to call them the Who Careites, or, you know, we should call it something really cool.
It has to have
a clever
name.
Like the Blades.
Like, it has to have a clever name.
The Razor Blades.
I don't
blades.
Know if you've looked on Netflix lately, but Netflix, they have
the
this
Ozarks?
New series. No, they have this new series called The Order.
Ooh.
And it's about a secret society, and then there's a, like, it kind of gets a little lame with the werewolves, but besides that part, it's like all secret society and stuff.
Well, why don't we do this? Why don't we put it to our listeners, to everybody?
If you had a secret society club,
well, what the fuck would you name it? And we would give you all the love in the world if you name it, because we'll take from it. We may not like it, but we probably will, because we don't really want to think about it. I'm just being honest. I have a lot of things to do. I have a lot of things, as you can see on that list, and I got this list, I got that list.
Full of lists.
Is it the list?
As long as you execute
is that the name
the
of this
items.
Society?
The list.
Yeah, you're on the list.
Damn. That's deep right there.
I don't know. Just email us at steven@whocaresthepodcast.com. And also, if you love lovely Miss Tori Michaels' outfit, she is a Catholic school girl, and she loves Catholic school.
Hey, I have nothing against it. My mom went to an all-girls Catholic school.
Fuck yeah, she did.
And she got kicked out.
Fuck yeah, she did. I was supposed to go to an all-boys Catholic school.
Ooh.
Servite.
Fuck yeah, you did.
Mm-hmm.
Just kidding.
Yeah.
Servite was an all-boys Catholic school?
Exactly. So I take the test.
Wait.
take the test, pass it, whatever. I'm sure it's real hard. But none of my friends are going there. And then I found out, oh, it's an all it's an all boys Catholic school? Yeah, I guess it is. Thanks a lot for telling me, parents. Well, they probably did.
I didn't know about that.
Right, but I looked around and saw who was taking that test. I thought, well, this isn't gonna do very well for me in school. Like, what do I have to look forward to every day? Mm-hmm. You know, like a lot of times when you go to classes, there's that good. You know, if you like the opposite sex, which I'm sure, maybe if I was a flaming homosexual at that time, not like now, just kidding. No, but like if I was one at the time, you know, I would have been like all for it. But at the time, I like to see a little variety, you know, not a bunch of sweaty balls.
I thought about going to an all-girls school, but then I was like,
See, but I feel like that's
not might not be for me.
And you know what they say, people who go to all Catholic school, or boys school, whatever, they say like, okay, but it's okay because there's sister schools.
They have like the boy all girls school and then the all boys school and yeah. they have dances or something where they like commune.
That doesn't mean they see each other every day, so they get to know who that person is. No. You got to see that person every day to like build up that like. Oh, fuck,
see,
does
that's
she
why.
Like me? Does she like me?
See, that's why I didn't like school for that.
What do you mean?
I didn't like school for
the
that.
Build up.
Yeah. No. I mean, there was the games of boys chase girls.
I'm still looking
like
for
that.
Because every time I go, I you know have relations. It's like just that night, you know, and it's like I don't get that buildup, you know. I don't work with them, really. And
do
if I
you
do,
want
I like that buildup.
You like the buildup?
Yeah, because it kind of gets you like, you know, like you put them on a pedestal. Hmm. And if it's fantasy or not, you put them on a pedestal. And then maybe you like them better because I seem to be very disappointed every time.
That wow. It seems a little tragic.
It's not really. It's just we have so many options now, you know?
Plenty of fish. Plenty of fish in the sea.
I mean, what do you think?
I think that there are a lot of people. And
that's funny. I said that to my dad. I said something. There's plenty of people. And my dad goes, "You're talking about girls."
What?
Or something like that.
Whoa!
I know,
is he on? Is he catching on?
Shut up!
I'm just kidding.
So, no, but it was funny because the way I said it sounded like it doesn't matter. I mean, it'd be rhinoceroses.
Maybe I don't know. My dad says new societies, their mentality of this whole bisexual thing is all messed up. And I was like, is it really? Like,
I don't know. But what about a pansexual?
What's that?
They look it up, but I believe it's anything.
Nah. Pansexual?
Yeah. Like, I mean, I'm not talking children. I'm talking about like. Anything like within the
not
realm
not limited to sexual choice
there
with
you
regard
go.
To biological sex gender.
What does that mean? Could it be
an
animal?
An example.
Could it be an animal?
Agreeable to many types of sexual behavior. I think I'm pansexual.
Could it be an animal?
Sounds like a good animal.
No. Jesus. I mean, because that animal wouldn't know. I mean, that animal, you know, doesn't have anything to say.
I don't know. It says... Is the sexual attraction to a person of a sex or gender furthermore termed bisexual? It's basically bisexual.
Huh.
With
but
multiple genders.
With Peter Pan. Yeah, okay, so what's that multiple gender?
It's probably like transgender.
Oh,
bisexual,
yes.
Like
it's all
them.
Human beings, though.
Yeah. Chicks with dicks, you know?
Gotcha. Well.
I mean, that could be like the whole package. You got the titties.
No, I'm completely, I understand that. So bisexual would just be... Man or woman.
Male or female.
But pan, pita.
Is everyone?
Pita pan.
Pita pan.
I wonder if that's where they get it from, pan. Or no, you get it from the pan.
Bread. Give me the pan.
Oh, pan dulce. Maybe they get it from that. Maybe they get it from pan, like pan, pancia, or what is it? Pan, the continents were together. Pangea?
Pandemic.
Pandemic? Oh my God, we're in a pandemic?
Pandemic.
And you're in a pansexual?
Pan.
You might be
the
leader.
Money, the money.
The money. The you pan. Might be the leader of the pandemic via pansexual. To every pansexual out there, can you please email us? Or here, you can get on the get
what's
in our chat box here.
The chat box?
It's right there.
What
it
is
right
that?
There. See the chat box?
Hello?
That's where you would be. No, to the left.
I think that everybody
that's
should
be
it. Chatting up on the chat box.
Chat. I love your outfit, though, because it does remind me of the times long ago.
I like your outfit.
Thank
you.
You
know what it reminds me of? You know Zach Slater from Save the Bell?
Well, first of all, it's Zach Morris. Or A.C. Slater.
Okay, well.
Him. I like Zach
because
Slater.
I liked both of them.
I like, no, okay? I know, because I'm Mexican and
you're kind of both of
that's
them.
That's right. You know what's funny
so
about
I
that?
So I said Zach Slater.
That's funny you say that because my, yeah, it's funny you say that because my buddy, shout out to Joe Fig, he used to call me Zach Martinez because he said I look like Zach Morris, but the Mexican version.
Mm-hmm.
So is that.
You got the Slater. Your little dimples and your smile. Aw.
That wasn't. Are we supposed to take a picture while we're doing it?
Really?
I don't know. I don't know where.
Is Sergio gonna call us?
I don't know either. Well, let's get to your topics. We have decided now. We've talked way too long.
Okay.
Right. We now have topics for everybody. Remember, this is sponsored here by What's Play Games, the Who Cares podcast. Go to our Twitter page at What's the Play app, or actually, we have our own Twitter page too.
Mm-hmm.
At Who Cares the podcast.
Mm-hmm.
But more importantly, go to What's the Play app. Join our Discord. Go to our YouTube channel. You're here on Twitch. Subscribe if good. I mean, that'd be fantastic because Miss Ashley needs 3 more Catholic school uniforms. And then that will be fantastic.
Fantastical. Well, as they say, get your coin.
Hey, have you ever thought about being a podcaster like myself? Well, you can't be like me, but I want you to be that innovative, that wonderful, spectacular voice that the world needs, but you got to come to the What's the Play family because we moved over here to Anchor. We left Spreaker behind and we moved over here to Anchor.fm because Anchor is your one-stop shop for recording, hosting, and distributing your podcast. Best of all, it's 100% free and it's ridiculously easy to use. And now Anchor can match you with great sponsors too, like myself, so you can get paid to podcast. So remember, go to anchor.fm/start and join me and the What's the Play family. You know how to get a hold of me. And make sure you do it today, because I can't wait to hear your podcast.
Get your coins, girl.
You did some crazy shit today.
What?
Pigtails?
Oh, this isn't
happening. No. But how you got around to it?
Oh, well, I don't know.
It's so good to see you, though. We had a wonderful day today, and I thank you again for. I'm sorry I was late.
No worries.
But I ate a slush puppy and 1,400
gum.
Were
you late, or were you just? You know,
I was
on
sick.
On your time. On your time. No, I got to sneak in a nap. I'm not gonna lie. I was happy you were a little.
Are you serious?
Did I not like
yeah,
tell
yeah,
you?
Yeah.
I was asleep. I was like, I was asleep. I wasn't like.
Thank God.
I was like, I needed that extra little cat nap.
That's
I can
right.
always do for it. That's the only way I'm able to, you know, stay awake.
But I want to say I'm very proud of you. I really am. I'm so proud of you. What you're doing, you're staying focused. You're killing it in every sense of the imagination, and you're not letting things get to you. You've actually been a voice of reason, which I couldn't have believed 5, 10 years ago, or whatever. And you've kept me steady. You kept everybody around you steady. And you're a shining light right now. And I think everybody should take notice and follow this girl's lead, man. Because you're doing some good shit.
Well, you just the key is not to get overwhelmed.
Like me.
Yeah, but you just make a list
and
you execute one at a time.
Keep talking about fancy stuff.
I'm just saying, like, it all started off with making a bed.
That's crazy you say that.
No, it's funny because
that warmonger guy.
No.
The
general? Before that all came out, like, it's always been a thing in my family. My mom's like, you gotta make a bed, you gotta make a bed. And I was always the teenager that was like, no, I don't want to make my bed.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just going to jump right back into it. It's going to be messy, and I like it when it's messy.
I mean, really, you have to make it again, just like mowing the lawn.
But right? It felt so damn
it
good.
It feels so good. When you go in the room, and you're like, oh, my God, I made my bed.
You
want to
know
nice.
Why? The psychological reason?
Yeah, because you did one thing in the day. Already.
Not only that, yeah, you accomplished the first task of the day.
Right.
So it sets the snowball in motion.
That's why when the gym was open, I like to go early in the morning, boom.
I have to do it in the morning. I'm a morning workout person.
Mm-hmm.
I love working out in the
morning. Yeah, because it sets the mood for the day.
But not only that, it also kickstarts your metabolism.
And you can eat whatever
and
you want to the rest of the day.
Well, because everybody has a different heart rate. And if you reach that heart rate for whatever age and weight you are for 30 minutes, that heart rate stays throughout the day, so you burn more calories and your metabolic rate quickens.
Well, jeez. I just thought like it made me feel better, and I was like,
well, yeah, no.
No, but I felt lighter. I feel lighter, so that makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Like right now, I feel fantastic.
Fantastical.
I do because I let my heart rate, I guess, raise every day. Mm-hmm. I've been going crazy at the gym, but then today old Gavin Newsom, who stole my voice, old Gavin Newsom, decided, hey, listen, everybody.
I'm a dick.
Yeah, pretty much. But let me ask you a question.
No, I have no.
Let me ask you a question. I don't want to get political about it because I really don't know the answer. I think this is the answer for everybody out there.
He's
this
just
is the
trying to protect people.
Maybe. But, well, I mean, how many people are there? You're that guy.
You're that guy earlier? No, I think, to be honest, I'm one of those people that it's.
You're optimist.
Well, no, there's been other pandemics just like this have died just as much, if not more.
Do you think
it's just they didn't have social media and the publicity it did back then?
Right. Okay.
During the Black Plague and all that stuff, they didn't have all this stuff. So nobody knew about it.
Are you saying the Black Plague was due to what? Black Plague?
Damn.
Why do they call it the Black Plague? Why gotta be black?
The bubonic plague. I think because their body parts would turn black and then die and decay and then.
Oh, really? That's what happens when you turn black? Is that what you're saying?
No.
I'm just kidding. No, because we're so uptight about that kind of stuff. That's what I wanted to bring your attention.
You can't make jokes anymore.
You can't make jokes. Well, mm-hmm. I'm not even making a joke.
No, like you can't make jokes anymore. I feel like comedians can't even be comedians.
Yeah, maybe we're not really comedians.
I don't know.
I'm just kidding. It's called the Who Cares Podcast for a reason.
I felt like I was always a comedian.
You are. You're fantastic.
Fantastical.
Let me ask you a question, though. Very, very serious.
Okay.
And it's not one way or the other. Do you think that all these protests, rioting in the name of I guess, Black Lives Matter and the police brutality, and other things too, right, had anything to do with the surge in coronavirus? Or was it the fact that maybe these governors got a little excited and they opened up gyms and whatnot, and then everybody starts doing that kind of stuff, and then people in Florida are fucking on the beaches, and I just saw a lot of the gay dudes at Fire Island got real excited. And they're talking shit into the Instagram, and they're saying like, I got COVID, I don't give a fuck, and crazy shit like that, right? Mm-hmm. So do you think it's a combination of all of it, or do you think one thing in particular is the reason?
I think the whole nation in whole has gotten fed up with being
quarantined,
restricted to certain measures, so everybody's laxed it and just said, fuck it, if I get it, I get it.
But I feel like people are wearing the masks.
They are, some.
I mean,
not everyone. There's still people that don't.
We weren't wearing them here in Orange County for a while. But we picked it up. But now...
I feel like the riots were not such a good idea for
I feel
the,
like the riots like definitely the, came at a wrong time.
Yeah, the whole notion of spreading it.
100. And not to take anything away from the movement and whatnot. Of course not. What happened to that poor man?
It wasn't the smartest measure at the right time, I guess.
Well, people had
but
it, though.
But people said they needed to make a statement.
So do you think there might be more riots... Because we're looking at Labor Day possibly that it's gonna all close down or it's gonna open back up. That's what's happening. So all of August, people are gonna be, and who knows if they even listen this time? Are you guys gonna listen? That's something very, very. And if you don't listen or if you want to, please jump in the chat here, or message us.
Are you pro COVID or
message
anti-COVID?
Us on Twitter. What's the app? What?
I actually did a poll recently on Twitter. Mm-hmm. How many people actually know
someone?
Someone that's had COVID, and it's a 50-50 rate.
Really?
Well, out of my followers, yeah. It's like 50-50, like half no.
Wait, did you do it on the What's Play app?
No, I think I did it on my personal one.
Oh, thanks for that. Maybe you should do it on now.
Yeah,
we're going to put up a poll.
Because we want to see what you guys have to say.
That's right. Well, who cares about what we have to say? We don't know anything.
Mm-mm.
But the people know.
Yep.
And our listeners and our followers, subscribers, are probably the smartest people on the planet.
They probably are.
So, you think? So do you think after Labor Day, when they think it's going to probably go to that, then it starts to open up again,
mm-hmm.
and then who's you think they're going to riot, or do you think nobody's even going to listen up until then? Maybe this time people aren't going to listen, and they're I'm going to keep my businesses open. What do you think that they're going to act out like?
I feel like they kind of already are right now because they closed all the dine-ins, but everybody's having tables outside now.
Right. He said today though, outside okay. To go, food okay, no inside.
Well, then is it really closed down then?
Yeah.
But it's not. It's still open.
Right. But other businesses, though, I'm saying.
I don't know.
Every other business besides that is predominantly, it's going to be closed. Like, to get your...
That's just a sudden, though, because, all of a sudden that's happening. Now, people aren't prepared. Are they going to start buying toilet paper like crazy again? I'm just saying.
I don't know. I mean,
are what happened? Lose their shit and buy all the food again?
How about this though? That we just found out today in California, or I guess it's nationwide, maybe the coins are being lost. There's a coin shortage, and if you go to Ralph's over here on Warner, mm-hmm. they don't give you your change back. They put it on a card, possibly, or you just have to change back. In fact, I was at when I got my slush puppy today. She goes, "Do you have the exact change?" I go, "What the fuck is this exact change? What is it? 1928? Yeah, she. I got some change in my pocket. Let me give you some change." Who uses change? So get rid of it anyways. Just how about they make the shit even? Just go the other way. Make it less than. You got to round up, round down.
You want the whole rounding?
I want to round it down.
Round it down.
Yeah, say it's $2.25. Just do $2. You don't need that 25 cent. Hey, you're lucky to be open, gas station. I mean, money is not value.
Dude, what's up with the gas station's bathrooms being closed? If you're out on the road and you're like on a road trip, there's nowhere to go to the bathroom anymore.
Well,
that is a serious problem. Because there's going to be like a lot of public indecencies.
You like the homeless too.
You can get a public. You want to be on the sex offender
list? They should take away that rule.
Sex offender list, you will get put on that just for peeing in public.
But VP, you should not be on a sex offender list from now on.
I know. If they
catch you peeing or having sex in public, you should not be on a sex offender list. You know how many times like I've wanted to, you know? Just like. But then I'm like, no, geez, we can't do that because I don't want to.
So
that I don't want to be like, I don't want to be on Mary's Law. What's it called?
Segues,
Murphy's Law?
Segues into another question or another story.
Okay, what are we calling this segment?
This last weekend.
What are we calling this segment?
I'm telling you, the story has to do with peeing in public, right?
Peeing in public.
Okay, so this past weekend.
Maybe this is the segment every week? Peeing in public.
Peeing in public. Latest peers in public. No, my dad actually went with me to Harbor and Freight. I don't know if you've been there before.
Harbor Freight.
Went to the Harbor Freight in Pasadena. Mm-hmm. So we go over there. We're trying to get some of those furniture wheel mover things.
Dollies?
Whatever, yeah. And so we buy a couple of those. We grab them. My dad has to use the restroom, so he excuses himself and goes to the restroom. Meanwhile, I'm browsing the store, like, oh, damn, Harbor Freight really is cheap as a shit.
It's pretty cheap.
Because it breaks. Yeah. Anyways.
You only use it like one time.
They're not Snap-on tools. But anyways, we're not going to get into
that. We're not even going to.
No. But
it might be a sponsor.
He just comes back like it's regular. So we go to my grandpa's house.
It looks regular.
He just comes back to the bathroom, from the bathroom. Doesn't tell me anything about what happened or anything. So we get back to the house, this older lady we're helping move her furniture, and he tells this story of going to the bathroom. And I was like, what do you mean? Like, what happened that was so exciting? So apparently there was another gentleman that had to use the restroom as well. And there were these two doors, two restrooms, these crazy locks that you had to